here I'm going to talk about these redox reactions definitions. There are two definitions we have to discuss. One is the classical idea of redox reactions. The second one is the modern idea of the redox reactions, we say. So what is the classical idea? This is the old concept of defining the redox reactions, we say. That redox reactions are classified into redox reactions divided into two half reactions, we say. One is oxidation, right? Other one is reduction. Why I am using these half reactions? So what is the because the oxidation and the reduction both are not isolated. These are not independent. Oxidation or reduction are not independent. Both means if there is oxidation, means reduction follows. If the reduction happen, means there is oxidation. Got it, everyone? You cannot isolate these redox reactions. Means oxidation and reduction separate. I think it is clear. So now the oxidation. What is the definition of oxidation according to the classical idea? Traditional definition of these redox reactions. Redox reactions. You learned in the 10th class the definition of oxidation. The definition of reduction is the classical idea. Have you learned in the 10th class the definition of oxidation?
Yes, sir. Yes.
So what is the definition you learned? Oxidation means what?
Addition of oxygen.
Addition of oxygen and removal of
what? Oxygen to what? Addition of oxygen to what?
Compound.
Addition of oxygen to an element. Okay. Addition of oxygen to a compound. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
This is the definition. And one more classical idea. This is addition. So if you add oxygen, something should be removed. What do you remove?
Hydrogen.
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 Removal of hydrogen hydrogen atoms from what? From the element, from the element in the compound, from the compound, am I right? So this is the definition, the classical idea of that. So what we call means oxidation, addition of oxygen atom, removal of hydrogen atoms, and the third one is also, what is the third one is Removal of electrons. Removal of electropositive. No, electropositive atom.
Yes, electropositive.
Electropositive atom is said to be what we call means. So removal of electropositive atom is said to be oxidation. And indirectly
addition of electronegative.
Fourth one can be right. Addition of electronegative atom. So what are the electronegative atom? Chlorine, fluorine, nitrogen, oxygen. So added to the any compound is said to be. So these are the four definitions we give for oxidation as per the classical idea. Similarly, define the reduction also. How you define the reduction?
Addition of H2.
Addition of H2, very good.
Removal of oxygen.
Removal of oxygen atoms. And addition of electropositive atom.
Addition of electropositive and removal of electronegative
atom. Just opposite to the oxidation.
Yes.
Of course, it is clear, everyone. Four definitions.
Yes.
Traditional concept. So now I will take the examples as per these definitions I will take the examples and we will discuss one by one. What is the example? First example is magnesium is a metal burned in the presence of oxygen gas. क्या आएगा? मैग्नीशियम ऑक्साइड आएगा. दिस इज अ सॉलिड प्लस एनर्जी बाहर आएगा, राइट?
यस सर.
सो नाउ हियर ऑक्सीजन इज एडेड टू द मैग्नीशियम. नाउ द मैग्नीशियम इज ऑक्सीडाइज्ड. द मैग्नीशियम इज ऑक्सीडाइज्ड, राइट? सो दिस इज ऑक्सीडेशन रिएक्शन. वी से एडिशन ऑफ ऑक्सीजन एटम टू दिस एलिमेंट. Addition of oxygen atom to this element, this is oxidation. We say the second definition is, what is that? Removal of hydrogen atom. So removal of hydrogen atom means there is a CH4 hydrocarbon gas is a burnt in the presence of oxygen to produce what are the products? CO2 plus H2O plus energy, heat energy you will get. So in this oxygen atom is added here. What are replaced? Hydrogen atoms are replaced. Hydrogen atoms are removed from this methane.
So
yes,
this is example.
But there they are also added.
Yes. Yeah. Oxygen is added, but so here oxygen is added here. What are removed? Hydrogen atoms are removed.
Hydrogen
yes. atoms are removed. Because from the carbon, hydrogen atoms are removed. We get right?
Yes, sir.
So, and the third definition is removal of hydrogen atoms after. So, a third definition is electropositive atom. But a third definition, what I told, electronegative atom first I will talk about. So, magnesium is reactive with the fluorine to form. What is the compound you will get? MgF2 aega. When magnesium metal is burnt, when hot magnesium metal is burnt in the presence of fluorine gas, so then we'll get the magnesium fluoride aega. And similarly, what you get means magnesium react with the chlorine, then forms into magnesium chloride. So what is added here? So halogen atom is added, chlorine is added here. Electronegative fluorine is the most electronegative added to the magnesium. Chlorine is electronegative added to the magnesium. So this is what we call means oxidation with respect to the electronegative. Addition of electronegative. Here also addition of electronegative to the magnesium. Oxidation. Right? So in some reactions, rarely sometimes what happens, electropositive atom. Removal of electropositive atom. So in what case the positive atom will be added? These cases are rare. Here, tetrapotassium, hexacyano, iron. This is a complex compound, aqueous solution. This is a metal complex compound. This is so potassium, ferro, siren. Potassium, ferro, siren. I am using here tetrapotassium, so hexacyanoferrous. This is a compound, metal complex compound this is. Plus, this compound is subjected to oxidation in the presence of hydrogen peroxide. So what happened means, we will get the compound is K3FeCN taken 6. So plus 2KOH is the compound we will get. Here, if you observe the this reaction, then and here, so this metal complex not undergoing any change. Observe carefully, Fe, so CN here, Fe CN 6 here. You can observe this is not undergoing any change, and what is undergoing change? Only the potassium number is changing. Potassium number is changing. You can observe, right? So here is the oxidizing agent this is. So now here from this K4, so the potassium atoms are replaced here. Here one potassium atom is removed now. From the metal complex compound, one potassium atom.
Yes, sir.
Potassium is electropositive or not? Electropositive metal no? Electropositive. Replace it from this metal complex compound. So here is KOH. Now I think it is a balanced you can check. So this reaction, so if you take, so here how many? 4. You can write 2 here, you can write 2. Now I think it is a balance. So this is the methyl complex reaction in which, so hydrogen peroxide acts as oxidizing agent. So what it will do means it remove this one potassium electropositive from this metal complex. Here K3, here K2 potassium hydroxide is formed. So this is also an example for what means oxidation. This is also an example for this is an example for what means removal of electropositive atom. What is that? Electropositive atom.
Positivity.
Now, classical idea, according to the classical idea, these are the definitions. Okay. Now, coming for the discussion. So what is that discussion means? What is reduction? So reduction. So after the oxidation, reduction follows. After the oxidation, reduction follows. Just now, what are the definitions we can write for the reduction? Addition of
hydrogen
atoms to an element or compound, right? Second one, oxygen atom. Oxygen atom is so from the element and compound. Third one is
addition of electropositive
atom. And fourth one is removal of electronegative atoms. So these are the definitions for the reduction, we say. And see, just now I told if there is oxidation, the reduction follows. Earlier I told the oxidation example, but in that reduction also happened. Did you observe or not?
Yes, sir, we observed.
So that means, see, for example, MgO, Mg plus O2, and magnesium is oxidizing, means what about the oxygen? Reduce it, no?
It is getting reduced.
See, if you write this equation PbO plus CO, and in this, what happened upon heating? Apo aega Pb plus, so then CO2 aega. So what is removed here?
First one, what will be the reaction?
What is removed here? Oxygen is removed.
Sir, first one, what will be there?
Sir.
First one?
Sir, he is asking in first one, what will be the reduction which will get?
First one is oxygen is reduced, means so here aapko milega oxygen will become electronegative, na idhar magnesium will become electropositive, no? Isme kya hoga? Magnesium is this is elemental form, but in this ionic form, no?
Yes,
it is
after chemical bond,
right, sir? Yeah, so that's what I'm telling. Here, if there is magnesium is getting oxidation, means automatically oxygen is oxidized. Oxidized, we say. So, because we cannot isolate this redox reaction. इसीलिए one is getting oxidation means so other one. That means formation of MgO is reduction. And so means formation of this oxygen, sorry, MgO. So burning of this magnesium is oxidation, we say. But what about the oxygen? Oxygen is reduced. And okay, one more I will tell you. So what is that reaction? This is cupric oxide plus hydrogen gas. Okay. For the reduction, I am telling cupric oxide solid, and this is the gas at high temperature. When this cupric oxide is heated in the absence of oxygen conditions, what happens? Can you guess?
CO plus H2.
Solid banega plus H2O aega. Now, what kind of reaction is this?
Redox.
So hydrogen atoms are added here.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Oxygen atoms are removed.
Removed.
And what kind of this hydrogen atom? Electro positive or electro negative? Batao.
Positive.
Electro positive is added. Electro positive element is added.
Yes, sir.
So addition of electro positive, addition of hydrogen atom. So. And what is removed from the cupric oxide? What is removed from the cupric oxide? Electronegative. Most electronegative atom is removed. So here, so with this, we can define the reduction also from this example. And one more. Okay. Sure, so sir. This is the example. We'll take addition of hydrogen atom and removal. And here sure. The copper. Oh, okay. In terms of the classical idea, these are the definitions. Now I will give complete means the redox reactions. As per the modern idea of redox reactions. So redox reactions. So oxidation can be defined as. In terms of electrons, and in terms of valency also. So, how we define the oxidation in terms of electrons? Oxidation can be defined as loss of electrons by an atom of element, loss of electrons. For example, sodium is an atom having 11 electrons, loses to become sodium plus ion, then we become 10 electrons, then electron comes out. The sodium plus ion is equal to the neon noble gas, nearest noble gas. It is a stable. This is oxidation, we say oxidation. Similarly, magnesium atomic number 12 losing how many electrons? 2 electrons, becoming 10 neon configuration, acquiring 2 electrons losing is said to be oxidation.
Yes, sir, oxidation.
And in terms of the valency defined, so oxidation can be defined as increasing of valency said to be oxidation. And what kind of valency? Positive valency. Valency we can't signify with positive and negative. If you mention in terms of positive means, what we write means increasing of oxidation state. Increasing of oxidation state. How much oxidation state? See, in case of the sodium plus 1, in case of the magnesium plus 2, and if you write aluminium plus 3, so oxidation state is increasing plus 1, plus 2, plus 3, right? So increasing of oxidation state also, what we call means oxidation, am I right? That means on the atom of the element, if you write the positive symbol, what does it signify? Positive symbol. The charge on the atom, if you write, what does it signify? Loss of electrons or gain of electrons?
Loss of electrons.
The loss of electrons are indicated with the positive sign, that is called oxidation state. So increasing of oxidation state, so plus 1, plus 2, plus 3, plus 4, plus 5, plus 6, up to plus 8 is said to be what we call means oxidation. Element getting oxidation or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Okay. So now this is the oxidation definition in terms of the loss of electrons and increasing of valency, also we say, or increasing of oxidation state, increasing of oxidation state also said to be oxidation, we write. And coming for the reduction, so reduction is quite opposite to this. So how you define the reduction in terms of the electrons, in terms of the valency, in terms of the oxidation state? Reduction is how you write gain of electrons by an atom of element, gain of electrons. Can you write one more definition? Decrease of valency, or we can write decrease of positive valency, or increase of negative valence. You can write increase of negative oxidation state. Negative oxidation state. We'll talk about later about oxidation state. Increasing of negative oxidation state. Gain of electrons, decrease of valency, increasing of negative oxidation state is said to be what we call means reduction. Example, chlorine, atomic number 17, require one electron. Banega chloride ion banega, right? So 18 atomic number, nearest noble gas, what is it? Argon, no?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Similarly, if you write sulfur gaining 2 electrons, capacity of sulfur accepting how many? 16. Gaining electrons how many? 2. Changing into S minus 2 ion equal to 18 electrons. Argon configuration, nearest noble gas, then it becomes sulfide ion. Sulfide banega. So sulfur plus 2 electrons getting sulfide ions. So by the reduction, these 2 electrons come from the magnesium, this 1 electron come from the sodium. And similarly, if you take oxygen atom, it gain electrons how many? 2 electrons, then it will become into oxide minus. So this is neon configuration, oxygen. All these reactions, so accepting electrons, gain of electrons by these atoms to become anion, to get anion, is said to be what we call means reduction. So Cl minus, chloride, fluoride, bromide, iodide, oxide, phosphide, sulfide, arsenide, all get reduction. Non-metals get reduction. Acidic radicals get reduction. So hence these are said to be what we call, these are getting reduction. These are getting reduction, that's why these are called oxidizing agent. Or these are called oxidants. Oxidants we call. Sometimes if we use the word oxidizing agent to reducing agent, we'll get the confusion. So chlorine, sulfur, oxygen getting reduction, hence these are said to be oxidizing agent. Now tell me, what are the reducing agent? What are the reducing agent?
Which gets oxidized?
Sodium metal, potassium metal, hydrogen, rubidium,
any metal,
calcium. So just call first and second group elements. In the periodic table, first and what are the first group? Alkali, alkali and alkaline, earth metals are strong reducing agents we call.
Yes, sir.
Because always they lose electrons, no? Always they get oxidation. There should be strong reducing agents. And the group in the periodic table, 17th group, 16th group, oxygen family and halogen family, nitrogen family are said to be strong oxidizing agent because they get reduction.
Sir.
Yes.
Sir, what about the third group?
Yeah. So what about the third group? What, which group you are asking about? Boron family?
Third and fourth.
Third and fourth means you are asking about boron family, you are asking about carbon family, right?
Yes, sir.
So third and fourth, that's what? Third and fourth having the specialty. What is the specialty? Carbon family. So they comes under bridge group, we say, between the alkali and halogens, because their electronegativity is not high, not low. That's why those elements will undergo both properties. So sharing property, they will. That's what carbon undergoes, sharing property. Means, does the carbon provide ionic bond? Does the carbon will form ionic bond or metallic bond? It doesn't form, no. So that's why carbon will undergo. Carbon always prefer to share the electrons because of what we call weak reducing property, weak oxidizing property. Got the point? Carbon also, okay.
Yes.
Carbon you can use as a reducing agent, oxidizing agent. So, but that property is not strong. I'm using the word. The first group and second group are strong reducing agents. Yaad rakhna, this is a very, very important point. And the 17th group and 16th group are said to be strong oxidizing agent. Sulfur is a strong oxidizing agent. Fluorine is a strong oxidizing agent. Chlorine is a strong oxidizing agent. And sodium metal is a strong reducing agent. Magnesium is a strong reducing agent. Metals are reducing agents, non-metals are oxidizing agents. Baat samajh gaye sabko?
Yes, sir.
So what about aluminium?
Aluminium is a reducing agent. Aluminium has reducing property. Metals have the reducing property. But if you compare metal to metal, this reduction property different hota hai na? See, electropositivity of aluminium sodium, is there any difference? Aluminium ka sodium ka electropositivity rate varies, or so which has more electropositive, sodium? Tell me,
yes,
sodium loses easily or aluminium loses electrons easily?
Sodium
undergoes oxidation easily. इसीलिए सोडियम इज अ स्ट्रॉन्ग ऑक्सीडाइजिंग रिड्यूसिंग एजेंट.
यस.
सो द मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ लूजिंग इलेक्ट्रॉन्स, नो, द स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ मींस द नेचर ऑफ लूजिंग इलेक्ट्रॉन्स इज द ऑक्सीडेशन. मोर इज द टेंडेंसी टू लूज, मोर इज द रिड्यूसिंग प्रॉपर्टी. More is the tendency of gaining electrons, more is the oxidizing property. So, oxidant, reductant. What is a reductant? Reducing agent. Don't get confused with these terms. Oxidant means OA. 17th group, 16th group, First and second group, yaad rakhna. This is a very, very important point for the discussion. Okay, this is our modern concept of. So now I'll take the example for this understanding of this modern idea of redox reactions. I'll take the example. So what is the example? I'll take. What is the name of this compound?
Hydrogen sulfide.
Hydrogen sulfide. This gas is a burnt. Hydrogen sulfide gas is a burnt. What happened? Guess karo. It is like burning. Yes, this gas is burning. Aapko aayega H2O aayega, pani niklega.
Yes.
Sulfur aayega. Sulfur aayega.
Yes, sir.
So now in this hydrogen sulfide, what is the most electronegative atom hydrogen sulfide mein? S minus 2.
Hydrogen.
S minus 2.
Sulfide is S minus 2, electronegative. Hydrogen is plus 1. Plus 1 into 2 kitna? Plus 2 no?
Plus 2.
So hydrogen is electro positive, sulfur is electronegative. So charges are equal now. Plus 1 into 2, plus 2, minus 2. Complete. And oxygen. Yes. Oxygen is in elemental form, no? Oxidation state is zero. See, for any element, elemental form, oxidation state is zero. Yaad rakhna, that is uncombined state considered. So zero oxidation state, we say. But in the water, you can see hydrogen is plus one into two, plus two. Oxygen is minus two. Clear, everyone?
Yes.
Now here what happened when the hydrogen sulfide is burning in the presence of oxygen, so sulfur is reduced. So sulfur element is formed here. So sulfur element is formed means then sulfur oxidation state I am writing zero. Now you can compare the oxidation state. Minus two changing into how much? Sulfur zero. Negative to zero means what we call? Negative oxidation state to zero means electron lost or gained? Batao.
Loss.
Electrons loss. That means sulfide S minus 2 changing into yes, that means 0. Minus 2 changing into how much means 0? This is oxidized. Sulfur is oxidized or reduced, batao.
Electron is losing, sir.
Losing of electrons means. So oxidation, no?
Oxidized.
Yes.
Oxidized. Sulfur is oxidized. Yes. Okay. And now hydrogen. Hydrogen oxidation state is remain same in both reactants and yes. Product remain same.
Yes.
So these are spectator atoms. Spectator atoms we call neither getting oxidation nor getting reduction. They are remain same. But sulfur changing from minus 2 to 0. But oxygen 0 to minus 2, no? Oxygen changing how much? 0 to minus 2.
Sir, oxygen is adding with hydrogen.
Oxygen is addition. So addition also, but oxidation state of the oxidation state or the of this element is zero and changing in the compound minus two. Electrons are gained or lost, batao. Means in terms of electron gaining and losing, I am talking about. Electrons gained or lost. Zero to negative sign. Zero to minus two means electrons are gained, no? Two electrons are gained.
Yeah.
Two electrons are gained means oxygen yes. Getting reduction. Sulfur is getting oxidation. This is so oxidation and this is reduction, no?
Yes.
In terms of electrons, even okay. So now I understood your doubt. So oxygen atom is added. Oxygen atom is added. For example, I am writing Mg example only. This is MgO, right? Burning of magnesium
yes.
To form the magnesium oxide. So magnesium is taken in the form of element. Elemental form of this element form is oxidation state is zero. That means valency of the elemental form is zero because it is uncombined state now. Magnesium is element is uncombined state.
Yes, sir.
uncombined state. Oxygen is also uncombined state. This is also elemental form. Elemental form of the oxygen is also zero. But these elements are combining. After combination, magnesium ka oxidation state kitna rahega idhar plus 2. Magnesium ka oxidation state kitna plus 2. And oxygen ka oxidation state kitna minus 2. That means magnesium losing how many electrons? 2 electrons bahar aayega. So magnesium atomic number 12. So losing how many electrons? 2 electrons. 10 neon configuration. Losing 2 electrons is said to be oxidation. Are you getting what I'm talking sir, here? And now,
no,
now oxygen
no,
atom
sir.
Taking. So gaining how many electrons? Magnesium electrons 2. Magnesium providing 2 electrons for the oxygen. Changing into O minus 2. Ye banega oxide. Isliye aap magnesium oxide bol rahe idhar. So two, this is oxygen 8 atomic number changing into 10 neon configuration. So oxygen is getting reduction now. Gain of electrons. Reduction is happening for the oxygen.
But there it is 2MgO.
Yeah, for the balancing purpose I have taken. No, this is the diatomic, it is a monatomic. So, ab equation balance karna.
But according to our old concept.
Yes.
According to old concept also, according to modern concept also, what is happening? Magnesium getting oxidation. According to old concept also, magnesium getting oxidation, no?
Yes, sir.
Yes,
and according to the old concept, oxygen getting reduction. So reduction means gaining of electrons.
Yes, sir.
So if you observe the crystal of MgO, MgO crystal mein kya rehta hai? Ions rehta hai na? So ions, what are the ions? Oppositively charged ions. Between them, what kind of force of attraction will be present? Electrostatic force of attraction. Electrostatic force of attraction binding the magnesium ions, cations and oxide ions, no, anions, no, and holding together to form the crystal. Crystal lattice banega. Between the magnesium plus 2 and O minus 2, between the oppositely charged ions, course force of attraction rahega. Electrostatic force of attraction is to be ionic bond, no?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So for the formation of ionic bond, so before formation of ionic bond, these two steps will happen. Those two steps are said to be, one is oxidation, other one is the reduction. Without oxidation, without reduction, ionic bond doesn't form. Means no formation of ionic bond without oxidation, without reduction. Right?
Yes, sir.
So, okay. So, this is the introduction about the redox reaction. Redox reactions introduction part. And tomorrow we'll discuss more. So about this, I will introduce the new concept, oxidation state.